Hello and welcome to the second video of the object-oriented programming in Roblox. So today I'm going to show you Metatables in Roblox. So in order to demonstrate, we're going to go into a script in service script service. So at its most basic form, a Metatable is a more powerful version of a table. So the two functions associated with metatables are setMetatable and getMetatable. And so these functions set the metatable and get the metatable, as they say. And so what these functions take in is they take in a table one and then table two. And what will happen if you use setMetatable is it will take table one and set the meta table of table one to table two. And I'll talk about what that means in just a second. And personally, I only use set meta table, so we're just gonna get rid of get meta table. I never use get meta table. And so let's just show an example of this. So let's say you have two tables. One of them is called meta table. One of them is called new table. And we are going to set the meta table of new table to a table called meta table. A lot of tables here. So if we print the get meta table of new table, this should return the meta table. So this returns like a little table thingy ID, and so that's most likely meta table. It's just a special ID. So with this line, we have set the meta table of new table to meta table. And you can do it this way, but a more efficient way is just taking this line of code right here and replacing it with these two curly braces. So there we go. So instead of saying new table, we can just do a normal table. And so what setMetatable can do is it returns the table that it is making, that it is giving a metatable or setting a metatable. So this would return a table. So it'd be the equivalent of saying local new table equals this. So those two are basically the same. This is simpler. It's in one line. Okay, so congratulations, you have made your first meta table. So this child table, or this new table, is referred to as a child, and this meta table is referred to as a parent. So the meta table is always referred to as the parent table or base table, and the table that you're making and setting the meta table of is known as the child table. So you may be asking yourself, why are these meta tables so useful in object-oriented programming in Roblox? And the reason is for metamethods. So metamethods are like the special little functions that each meta table has, and there are a bunch of them. I will link them all in the description. But there's w only one that I really use, and it's index. Index. So each meta method is referred to by the double underscore and then whatever meta method it is. Right now it's index. And so this meta method is called whenever the child table tries to index something that it does not have. And so what will happen is let me show you an example. When you use a function for index, it would be index equals function, and then it takes in two arguments, the table, the child table that is trying to index something, and the index that it has. So what will happen here, that's a typo, if we print the table and the index, this is for demonstration purposes, and let's just say that new table tries to index something it doesn't have, like hello. And then we set that equal to like, actually we try to, I don't know, print that. Print new table hello. So let's run this. So you can see what prints first is this print statement right here, which it prints the table that we have and the index, hello. And then, of course, new table, hello, is not equal to anything. So it prints nil underneath that. And so I personally never use this function. What's more useful to me is setting the underscore underscore index to the metatable itself. So the way I like to do this is, since you can reference a key of a table using a period, I do, it's not a function actually, my bad. It's metatable dot underscore underscore index equals metatable. So what this statement right here is saying, this is one of the most crucial statements you should know in metatables. When you set the metatable dot index to itself, what this will do is, if we do the same thing, we try to refer to new table. Hello? I did that wrong. New table. Hello? It will say, hey, new table does not have an index called hello. So it'll be like, okay, so there is an index set in the metatable. So now it's set equal to this table, which conveniently refers to the metatable that it's indexing. And so now we're going to look through metatable to see if we can find what new table is trying to index. So if we have in metatable, we do metatable hello equals 5. What this will do is it'll print 5. So basically what that means is print new table hello says, oh, there's no key called hello, but there's a metatable, so we can check through the metatable. It's like, oh, look, metatable does have one called hello. So it sends it back to the new table. So this is so, so useful. There are so many applications for it. So before we talk about the applications of metatables, there is one more important thing that we have to talk about, and this is using the variable called self. So let's just make a function to demonstrate this. So metatable dot print something. So what this will do is it'll print metatable. It will print metatable dot hello. So let's just say we set new table dot hello to 7. And then we want to do new table dot print something. So some might think that when we run this function from the child table, it would use the metatable variable as the child table calling it. But that's not the case. So we run this, it prints 5, not 7. Because as you recall, we set metatable hello to 5. So if you want to access variables from a child table using a function in the parent table, you have to use something called self. So let's send in new. What you could do, this is a basic way, this is not using self, but just to show something. If we do something like this, this would print 7. But if you have a giant metatable with many functions, many things, you don't want to put this variable in front of every one. So an easier way is using a colon for a function. So whenever you use a colon in a function, it says, let's just use an example here. It goes, okay, so new table is calling print something, and it's using the colon. So that means we're going to send new table as a variable. Well, you might be like, oh, how are we going to get this variable if it's not defined in the parameters up here? But there's a special variable called self. So this self variable, it's highlighted in red, as you can see. It is whatever calls this function. So if the metatable calls it, it'll send a metatable. If the new table calls it, it'll send in a new table. So, for example, if we play this, this prints 7 instead of 5 because hello for the new table is set to 7. Hello for the metatable is set to 5. But if we use the metatable and do print something to the metatable, it does 5. And so, yeah, that's a basic overview of metatables. And these metatables are very, very useful for many things, whether it be making a bunch of tools that can inherit from a main tool class with some basic functions, or making a bunch of game modes that inherit from one basic game mode metatable. I actually use that in one of my games right now. So the primary use of these, like in total, is to save you time, space, and make it easier to make changes. Because, for example, if each table that you had in your game had a function called print something, and you needed to change something about that function, you would have to go through each one, copy and pasting, or even deleting scripts if you had a bunch of scripts, which I highly discourage. Always try to keep as limited scripts as possible. But when you have metatables, and if each of these tables accesses this metatable and uses this function print something, if you want to make a change, then you just put it here, and then boom, you're done. That's it. So, yeah, that's basically it. Metatables are super, super, super useful. In the next video, I'm going to talk about another powerful tool in Roblox in combination with metatables, which are module scripts. It will be an intro video to module scripts. And after that, I will talk about how you can use module scripts and metatables to make the ultimate object-oriented programming model in Roblox. So stay tuned. Make sure to like and subscribe. And goodbye.